Good evening. Welcome to the Sutter Theater Center for the Arts. Thank you all for being here. I'm David Reed. I work with the Yuba Sutter Arts Council. And great to see a lot of familiar faces and some new faces as well. Who hasn't been here since we've kind of reopened? We're all just been done. So, all right, great. New visitors. We hope you'll be watching what we've got to offer in the months and years ahead. So thank you all for being here tonight. And thank you again for complying with our COVID policy. We're sorry for the inconvenience, but you know, it's something we got to do right now. So any big band fans in the house tonight? This will be an incredible evening. We're just so excited to be able to host this amazing group of professional musicians and arts educators, and appreciate all the time and effort that they've put into getting us to this point this evening. Lots more concerts to come next year, so you'll be reading those announcements before long. It turns out musicians really like to do what they do, right? And appreciate opportunities to perform, so it's like, And we're just so pleased and honored to be able to provide this opportunity. When Gay and Deanna started talking about this, of course, we said, yes, what can we do to help? So providing rehearsal space and now performance space and a little bit of music, and I don't know, we've got some other things on the wish list, I know, so we're excited to keep this program going at the Yuba Sutter Big Band. A couple of special thank yous this evening. I want to recognize Donna Clark, who's here this evening. You're in the Clark Family Theater, in case you didn't notice on the big sign on the way in. Thank you to Donna and Russ for their great investment in this facility for so many years. I also recognize Nancy Toscano, who, along with her husband John, basically built the place. So, sorry I had my back to y'all. I didn't want to disengage the entire microphone setup that Gay's got here. So, very excited. Thank you all for your contributions. What else? Huge faux pas on our part. In spite of all of our best efforts to proofread the program, we left off one very important musician, Christine Buxted, the vocalist. We will be republishing the program, and Christine will get a framed copy with her name right there. So our sincere apologies, Christine. So what else? I'll get out of here, and let's get the concert started. Thanks again for being here.
Thanks to Dave and Abby, who make this whole thing work logistically and in so many ways, including cleaning sometimes. I've seen them at that. So this is our very first performance. We sort of started getting together last summer, and we thought, oh, maybe sometime this spring we would have our first performance. Christmas applause show didn't happen, so we suddenly had openings and we could do this. So thank you all for joining us. Our first number is in Kansas City.
Here we go.
Thank you.
So solos there, but first it was Becky. I just didn't hear Spanish to say this. James was second, then we went back to Mike, and last one was Gary. All right, we have a little bit of Christmas cheer for you now with the big band. Ah, strobing. That will be very interesting.
The big bang?
The big bang. I know Chris will get that under control. It was interesting. That's when we do the disco music later on.
And one.
Is open just to make a dance floor, so hope more of you join.
What? Dance floor?
Dance floor, yes, right there. And I know we had James Lohman on solos, and was that John Parker here, right?
Yes, again. Oh, okay.
I think you've all heard this one before.
Thank you.
They're off, oh, no, okay. So this next piece features our flautist, Becky, and we're going to be playing nice Latin chants for anyone who wants to be up there. Show us your Latin stuff, that'd be great. Hello. Let me turn it up. You might want to step away. Maybe we need to turn the piano mic a little bit. Test. Yes.
Oh, Hey, Christine.
And we would have her on more. She's just, this is Maggie she can commit to while doing her master's and teaching a couple jobs and teaching privately. She said 4 was all she could do this time. Hopefully she'll do more next. This next tune, I have a very famous tune. Most of the kids, my students, piano students, have actually heard this one before. They all want to play it. It's a little trickier than it looks, so we don't get too much. And we'll be starting out with our featuring our drummer, Ron Bowie, a little solo. And then keep it selfish. 1, 2, 3, 4. Chris was on, I can't tell you. Is it still ringing in there? It's okay? Right there. Thanks, Chris. All right, Stan Canton, too. We don't have the four or five trombones everybody has. But our two and our baker, Yuba, will fill in as well as they can. Definitely a slow dance. This next tune was part of the, it actually wasn't part of the swing revival, but it kind of got brought back by the swing revival. It was actually a Louie theme tune to start with. We will do our best to sound like Louie and the revival all at once. And it's definitely an up tune for dancing. Got it? You guys got your loops all ready to go? One, two. One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
We have one more team to set for you. And this, I believe he is Pablo, is that correct? If I remember that correctly. Got my name straight. Team that Santana did with Rock Thomas, Rock Thomas tune originally. And now we have a big name to try for. Now one, two, now one, two, three, boom. Christmas drink invented just for this band, the big band Christmas drink. at the bar, or get some sweets or some refreshments, and we'll be back in here.
Hey, everybody. All right, we're about ready to start the second half. Just wanted to say a couple of things. First, if you're enjoying tonight, of course, tomorrow we've got, during the Christmas stroll, we've got the welcoming back for, the fifth or sixth year, Dan, as best we can tell. A lot of these same musicians are going to be here for a tuba Christmas. A lot of your favorite Christmas carols played on all brass instruments. So. Yeah, tuba. Is that euphonium? Or yeah?
That's euphonium
for
invited tomorrow.
Yeah. I hear Deanna might be playing her euphonium. Is that true? Wonderful. Okay. There was a week of a music teacher a couple of years ago. She billed herself as the euphonium expert. What do you call it? Virtuoso. Anyhow, so that's tomorrow here at 6:30 with everything else going on with Christmas stroll. So please come in. I understand the musicians used to play in the lobby before this phase was finished. So come and enjoy that concert in the lap of luxury. I just want to thank Christine Buckstead again, our vocalist this evening, and thank you, Christine. You know you're also a percussionist, right? Wearing many hats. I also want to mention a dear friend and volunteer of the century, Christopher Bolton, who's running Lights and Sound. Not just because he's running Lights and Sound tonight, but because he's basically building the system. So it's still a work in progress, but, you know, it's kind of cool. It's come a long way, just even in the last week. So we appreciate all of Chris's time and effort and sweat equity getting us to this point. So. What else? Next weekend, Saturday night, 7 o'clock here, Mr. Gay Galvin, Tom Galvin, will be here doing Tom Galvin sing-along. And more than that, it's also a little background on some of our favorite Christmas songs. So it's fun to hear the story. You know, you dig a little deeper, you know, so much of the music we're so familiar with. But how did it really come about? So we're looking forward to that concert. Then we're going to take a little bit of a break, and then we'll kick things off back in January. So, what have I forgotten? Anything else? Again, thanks for being here this evening. However you get your information, however you found out about this concert, please keep doing it. Word of mouth is great. We do everything else that we can. Social media. There's still some of those newspaper readers in the room. E-newsletter once a month. We'll send you a postcard if you like snail mail. Sign up, let us know. We'll try to make you aware of not just our stuff. We try to collaborate with all the other arts councils in the community. Yuba College has got a big concert going tonight. And you know, some of our guests had to run out there to catch the second half, so we're always sorry for those double bookings, because there's really a lot going on here. Kind of tune in and check it out. Sunday afternoon, tomorrow and Sunday afternoon, the Yuba Sutter Master Chorale is performing. Saturday in Yuba City, Sunday afternoon in Marysville. So. Check out the Master Chorale. If you like vocal music, choral music, they do a great job. So, and Yuba Sutter Arts, this is the tail end of our 40th year in our existence. And support us, you know, being here tonight shows a great deal of support. If you can join up as a member, please do. So thanks for all you do, and again, thanks for being here. Have a great Christmas, happy holidays, and Gay, back to you.
Especially, you have to come to the Christmas sing-along on Saturday, next Saturday. Because my husband's doing it, and he does a great job. He makes really interesting backstories, and he gets you to participate. So we're going to start with a Barry Manilow tune, believe it or not. See if you recognize it.
Thank you. Thank you.
And that was our first husband and wife duo soloing tonight with Scott on the trumpet and Becky on the flute. Features our trombone player. And you may notice we're a little short on trombones, so I think we're adding one more, but there's always room for more trombones. And any of you up here, big bone trombone players, big band trombone. A jazz guitarist, yeah, we can't give up on that. Any jazz guitarists? So Mike is going to kick this next tune off. But not too.
Thank you.
Mike, Larry did part of the solo too. That's smart of you to bring your family. He's got the best looking family. So speaking of Pablo, Cherry Pink.
Thank you.
Thanks to the dancers, that made it so much more fun. And Ron, next, I'll leave the song with a count off. I'm going to... We are welcoming back Christine Buxton. This is a question many of us ask the men in our lives often. That was very sexist of me. I'm sure the husbands ask this of the wives. The title is, Why Don't You Do Right?
Turn up the mic.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
for changing place. Anybody who plays a solo on that one, stand up. Unless you're a trumpet player, then just probably hold your trumpet up high. We are drawing near to the end. This won't be too silent yet, but we would like to play one last carol for you. Nice little silent night. One, two, three, four.